In the previous lesson, we learned how to use the 2D object snaps. In this lesson, we are going to learn some other auxiliary tools that help us control the precision of our drawings. First and foremost, we will talk about the ortho mode, which restricts the cursor orthogonally. The ortho mode can be found in the status bar. In case this icon does not appear in your computer, you can click on the customization icon in the lower right corner and check ortho mode. Once I activate ortho mode, it becomes a lighter shade of blue. To get a better understanding of what it does, I will activate the line tool and click somewhere in the drawing area to specify the first point of the line. As I move the cursor, notice that the ortho does not allow me to create a line with an angle different than 0, 90, 180 or 360 degrees. I will click to create a horizontal line, and then I will click once more to create a vertical one too. Then I will press Escape to deactivate the tool. So if I want to create solely horizontal and vertical lines, it's easier with ortho mode active. The next auxiliary tool that can be extremely handy is the object snap tracking. This tool tracks the cursor along vertical and horizontal alignment paths from object snap points. Again, if this icon does not appear in your computer, you can click on the customization icon in the lower right corner and check object snap tracking. I will click on it to activate it, and I will also open the snaps list to make sure endpoint and midpoint are both active. As you may have already understood, this tool works in combination with the snaps we learned in the previous lesson. Let's say I want to draw another rectangle that's aligned with the existing one. I will select the polyline tool, and before I click to specify the first point, I will move the cursor on the upper right endpoint of the existing rectangle. Be careful, I didn't click yet. Once the name of the snap appears, I will move the cursor to the right and notice that a reference line appeared. Now I can either click on a random point on the line or type a number to define the distance between the two rectangles. In this example, I will type the number 7 and I will press Enter. The first point was specified, so now I'm going to move the cursor to the right, type the number 8, and press Enter to define the width. Next, I will move the cursor downward, type the number 10, and press Enter again to define the length. At this point, I am going to use the reference lines again to create the rest of the rectangle. I will move the cursor on the first point I specified, and once the word endpoint appears, I will move the cursor down. The reference line combined with the ortho mode snaps the cursor to the right point, so I will click there. Lastly, I will click on the left endpoint of the upper linear segment and press Escape to finish the creation of the rectangle. Now, I am going to place a point in the center of this rectangle without using the geometric center snap. I will activate the point tool and I'm going to hover the cursor on the midpoint of the upper side of the rectangle. Once the name of the snap appears, I will move downward and notice that again, a reference line appears. Now, I am going to hover the cursor on the midpoint of the right side of the rectangle, and once the word midpoint appears, I will move to the left, so this reference line will appear too. The center of the rectangle is where the two reference lines intersect, so this is where I will click to place the point. I will deactivate the multiple points to show you one more helpful tool. This tool is called Polar Tracking and it can be found in the status bar too. Polar Tracking, as its name indicates, tracks the cursor along specified polar angles. On the occasion that this icon does not appear in your computer, you can click on the customization icon in the lower right corner and check Polar Tracking. Once I activate it, I will click on the arrow next to it to select the polar increment angle. Let's say that I want to create two lines, both starting from the center of the circle. The first line I will create will be at a 30-degree angle from the existing one, so I will select the corresponding option from the list. Then I will select the line tool and click on the circle center to specify the first point. Notice that as I move the cursor, every 30 degrees a reference line appears. I will move the cursor carefully until the first reference line appears, and when it does, I will type the number 11 to specify the length of the line. At this point, I will exit the line command, reopen the polar increment angles list, and select the option that shows a reference line every 15 degrees. I will activate the line tool again and click on the circle center again to specify the first point of the line. This time, as I move the cursor, a reference line appears every 15 degrees. Once I reach 135 degrees, I am going to type the number 11 and press Enter to create this line too. So, as you can see, AutoCAD provides us with some very useful tools which help us draw with precision quickly.